We're learning more about the deadly shooting in Dayton, Ohio as well. That shooter targeted people outdoors in a downtown entertainment district. Dayton's mayor said that the shooter killed 9 people and injured 26 in less than a minute using an AR-15 style rifle with a high capacity magazine. Joining me now is Ohio's Democratic Senator Sherrod Brown. Senator Brown, thanks so much for joining us on this horrible day. Obviously, all of us watching are offering our deepest condolences to everyone in Dayton and in the state of Ohio. The shooting happened just 13 hours after the horrific massacre, the terrorist attack, really, in El Paso. What was your reaction when you heard the news of what was going on in your home state?
Well, you know, of course, sadness, but also anger, because I spoke to the mayor earlier this morning, Mayor Whaley, who's mayor of that great Ohio city, and she said she has gotten literally dozens and dozens of texts and emails from mayors around the country offering condolences but advice, because they have seen this in their cities, city after city after city. And the response I had, in addition to sadness, is anger that Congress still doesn't do its job. The House of Representatives has passed background check legislation. The Senate could meet tomorrow. I hope that Senator McConnell would bring the Senate back tomorrow and pass the background check bill and send it to the president. The president must sign it, period.
The mayor of Dayton had an emotional reaction at a press conference earlier this morning, describing how she felt having her city join that long list of places in America to experience a mass shooting. Just this year, having it so close to home must make it even worse. I mean, I know you've been trying to stop mass shootings, but tell us about what it's like for people you know to be involved.
I know Dayton very well. I've been in the Oregon District 40 or 50 times probably in my life. And it's just hard to understand why this happens and how this happens. And it's particularly hard to understand why our government continues to let it happen. I was part of the bill many years ago to ban assault weapons in this country. It passed with a good vote. It was the law for a number of years. President Bush II supported it. But because of the NRA, Congress did not renew the assault weapon ban, and it worked. The assault weapon ban was working. The fact that this many people were killed and injured, you reported in less than a minute. The mayor told me it was less than 30 seconds from the first shot until the police arrived and killed the shooter. And she said to me, hundreds could have died if the police response hadn't been that quick. That's the only good news in this, how great the police response was. But the fact that he had a weapon that could have, that an assault weapon that could have shot, that could have killed so many people with enough bullets, enough magazines to mow down virtually anybody along that street and in those clubs and in those buildings, just tells me that Congress has just got to act and say no to the gun lobby for the first time. And Mitch McConnell's life as the leader of the Senate.
We have some indication as to what motivated the alleged terrorist shooter in El Paso. Do you have any information you can share with us about the identity or the motive of the Dayton shooter?
Only that the mayor said it was a young white male. I believe she may have said his age. I believe early 20s, but I don't know for sure. He came not from the city of Dayton. He came from a town in Montgomery County nearby. That's the county Dayton's in. That's all that I know. I assume the police already know a good bit more than that. Connie and I are on our way to Dayton soon after this interview is completed. We've left our home in Cleveland early this morning. We're heading south and going to Dayton, and we'll be there sometime this afternoon.
Is there any reason to believe that there's any connection whatsoever between what happened in El Paso and what happened in Dayton, either a copycat or a similar white supremacist ideology? Is there any indication as of now?
I have no way of knowing that. I would just hope the president would stop the divisive racist rhetoric that he has employed increasingly. He did it in the campaign in 16. Many thought that would be enough to keep him from winning, but more importantly, he does it even more now. And I just remember what Barack Obama did after Sandy Hook and what Barack Obama did after after Charleston. He went there, his job was to heal the country and to comfort to comfort people, the victims and families, and comfort the whole country and to heal the country. And I go back to President Bush, the second President Bush after 9/11. He went to a mosque and he said, Muslims didn't attack our country, terrorists did. And I wish the President of the United States would show the leadership of either of his predecessors and stop the racist, divisive talk and start the healing process.
Some of the Democrats running for president not only are faulting the president for his rhetoric, but they're saying that that rhetoric, in their view, you heard Congressman Beto O'Rourke maybe, leads to this, causes violence. Do you agree or does that go too far?
I don't know. I can't prove anything, but I do know that we've had two presidents, the two preceding presidents who dealt with terrible terrorism and mass shootings, tried to heal, and this president doesn't. I know that white supremacists feel empowered with this president. I know that. It's clear they feel empowered when he attacks people, and I saw the chants coming out of the crowd in I think, North Carolina, to send them back, and I just, it just breaks my heart, because we've never had, our country is better than this. Our country is just better than this kind of divisive, racist talk by a president of the United States, and I'm just always praying and hoping for something better. I guess the thoughts and prayers that my colleagues that always stand with the NRA, I guess I hope their thoughts and prayers will go for the president to begin to heal and stop the racist, divisive talk. And I would hope some of my colleagues would, one, stand up to the gun lobby, and second, would actually talk to the president about doing better about all this.
You noted that the U.S. Senate, which time and again from Sandy Hook to Parkland has failed to take any action to try to make sure that guns do not get into the hands of people who would use them against innocent people. Right now, there is a bipartisan background check bill that the House passed in February, as you noted. It's waiting to be taken up by your chamber. Do you have any confidence that Majority Leader McConnell will even allow a vote on it?
I know the power of the NRA. I've had a lifetime F from the NRA in my political career. I know that they've spent a lot of money against me. I know they attack politicians like me, and I know that my Republican colleagues that are supported by the NRA know that. And I don't know that they lack courage, but they certainly have shown no sign of standing up to the gun lobby. And I don't know what to say to that question about what the chances are. I just hope that public officials will do their job, and their job is to stand with the American people and stand up for public health and public safety in a better society. And I will say again, how important it is that Mitch McConnell call the Senate back on Monday. We could pass the background check bill in an afternoon and people could get back on a plane and go back to their homes and their children and grandchildren and whatever else they're doing in August in the evening. We could do it that fast, and we'd do a resounding vote, and the President of the United States perhaps would feel compelled to sign the bill.
There are more than 20 people running for president in your party, the Democratic Party, right now. Many of them have proposed far more sweeping gun legislation beyond universal background checks, everything from gun licensing from Senator Cory Booker to gun buybacks. Now, you're from what is now a red state. You've been in the Senate since 2007. Do you think your party should focus more on gun proposals that can get through the Senate as opposed to more far-reaching plans? What are your views on that?
Well, I want to do something in response to this awful series of attacks on our on citizens, defenseless citizens. And you start with the background check bill tomorrow, and then Congress gets serious about the assault weapon ban, which Congress has passed in the past with bipartisan support. A number of Republicans supported it. President Bush supported it. I believe he never signed it. To be clear, President Clinton signed it, but President Bush tried to get it through the Congress to renew it when it expired. So there have been prominent Republicans that support this. Those are two things we could do. We could do quickly, and I don't know what's next after that. We know that both of those work, and we know that In my state, the gun lobby is every bit as powerful with the governor and with the state legislature as it is in Washington, and I pray that my state will respond and do the right thing here too.
Senator Sherrod Brown, Democrat of Ohio, it's always good to see you, sir. Sorry it's under these circumstances. Good luck in Dayton today.
Thank you, Jake.